Well, hi everybody, and welcome back to Setting Up Your Assignment in Moodle 2.8. This is video number 2, and we are continuing where we left off with the Turnitin module in the Assignment Setup section. This is new. I'm kind of excited you no longer have to go out and get this and set it up. It's built right into your assignment. If you want to use it, and you've used the Expand All as we did in our last video, it's right here and available to you. If you don't want to use it, come up to where it says Turnitin, click that little diamond, and it goes away. I'm going to click it again so we can talk about it. And notice you have the Quick Mark Manager option, and I'm going to click that. And this is going to allow you to build a Quick Mark series of guidelines that you wish to use. Clicking on the screen removes that option. Enable Turnitin, you must set that to yes to enable the Turnitin features. The rest of these things are basically faculty decisions. Notice the wide variety of choices. When should the file be submitted? Allow submission files of any type. Store the student papers. Check against stored papers. Check against the internet. There's a lot of stuff down here. When you get to this little break, attach a rubric to this assignment. There is a rubric manager. Give it a click. It too will activate. And I'd never used this before, but I was able to put together a fairly effective rubric by selecting criteria and scales. I'm again going to click the screen. We'll go into both of those features in an advanced video, and it is important students will be able to view the attached rubrics prior to submitting. That helps you guide the direction of an assignment. And as we continue down the page, you'll see more options. You can also go to the Turnitin site for additional information and support. In the grades, the only real thing that's different here, most people are going to use points. I'm not a big believer in scales because credit, no credit, gives students 2 out of 3 ways to get an F. Full credit is 100 points, half credit is 50. That's an F in my grade book, and of course 0 is an F. Better to use a 5-4-3-2-1 or even a 1 and 0 grading method. The one thing that's different is maximum points. It used to be we had a big drop down. Well, now let's say I want this assignment to be worth 200. I'm just going to type 200, and if I click enter, it's going to throw me back to the front page. So enter your 200 and then just continue working. Simple direct grading. Choose your category once those grades are once those categories are set up. Blind grading, grading workflow, these are all in-class choices. The blind grading is kind of interesting. It takes the person's name off the paper, so you just read the content. Common module settings, if you feel the need to put in an ID number, call me. I'll talk you out of it. Don't do that. And restrict access is, as my grandfather used to say, too much gun for the squirrel. If you click it, you can add some restrictions. It's a little bit more user-friendly, but most of the things you're going to want to do, as we'll scroll up here to the top, we're going to choose our dates and availability here at the top page where we talked earlier. Please do not use this bottom as we scroll back down to the bottom of the page. Please do not use this restrict access to simply open and close your assignment. Okay, when you're all done, choose the save and return to course. Notice our assignment is now created with the title, and afterwards there is the description that we added. If you wish to change the title right after I have paper 1, notice there's a little pencil. You can click on the pencil. Notice the area will highlight. You can change the name and press enter without having to go all the way through the editing process. One other thing I promised to show you before we left, let's go over here to the activities block in the right hand choice, and notice it says assignments. Let's click assignment. We should just have the one, and here it is, paper 2 with the dates, etc. Let's go ahead and click on the assignment name. Under where it says paper 2 or the title of the assignment, the description you provided will be displayed, and that can be checked up on by the students. Also, you, as a professor, where it says view and grade all submissions, have the opportunity to do your grading right here and have it go into the grade book. We'll be covering that in the grade book videos, so we hope you'll join us for those. Our next video series is going to be on setting up forums, and we hope you'll join us for that or come by the Moodle Support Team office in Library 315 for some one-on-one workshop assistance. Thank you.